Hey everybody, Nick here. We have made a really stylish version of this bar chart before in a couple of videos. I'm going to link above and below to those. Make sure to work your way through those first because we're going to start with this canvas. We've already made this really cool chart, this sort of standardized clustered bar chart, but we've embedded the legend labels in those top bars, the annual pass holders and general public. But what if we made a chart that was like this, with the category labels on the top of the bars instead of off to the side of the axis? Now, I saw this chart on Instagram. I think it was a New York Times post, but I really liked it. The category labels are on top of each of the clustered bars, but those legend labels are still embedded in the bar. And there's just a little bit of a workaround that I think we can add to our previous chart to make this happen in PowerPoint. So what I'm gonna do is escape out of this slide. We're gonna go to our test chart right here, and I wanna open our data source. So remember, we can just right click and then click on Edit Data or Edit Data in Excel. That's going to pop up our editing window. And once that Excel window pops up, I'm going to drag it over here so that you can be reminded and you can see how we set this up. Now it requires a little bit of a workaround here. So you can see our data. I'm going to try to push this over here so we can see it a little bit better. So we have our data here, our general public data, our annual pass data, and then our helper columns or our dummy columns here, the general public and annual pass holder. Those are for our labels. So in order to get a label on top of each of those bars for the category labels, we are going to go ahead and add a couple of extra helper columns to this data source. Now, if I add a helper column right here, this is going to be sort of a spacer column. We're going to need to add two because this chart, remember, is on a primary axis and a secondary axis. We have two bars of data on the primary axis, and we have technically two bars of data on our secondary axis. So we need to mimic those one for one on each of those axes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and I'm going to insert a column right here. I'm just going to call this a label spacer, just to get this right. I don't need to put any data in this column. And then here, I'm going to say my category label, category labels. I'm just going to say category labels there. And here we are going to want some data. So I'm just going to put in values of 30%. And I'm just going to add that down the row, 30%, 30%. 30%, and you can see behind the scenes, my chart is starting to take a little bit of shape right here. Now let's go ahead and let's close out of this and just look at the lay of the land here. Now, something is a little bit off here because you can see that my I have three columns of data right here. Maybe what this looks like could be the prime or the secondary axis. Those are my labels, but then this is kind of overlapping and I don't really have three there. So I'm wondering if I needed to put a spacing, kind of a spacer piece of data inside that other column. So let's go ahead and edit the data again. And what I'm going to do is in our label spacer column right there, I'm just going to put in 10% and see what happens. Okay, that goes there. I know. I got it. Actually, you know what? I'm going to delete that. I know exactly what we need to do. So I'm going to close out of this. Forget everything that I just said. Actually, let's go ahead and just open that again and get rid of it. Let's see if we've got that. Oh, okay, good. It's all gone. Okay, everything is gone. Now, the thing is, it looks weird, but that's because some of our extra columns that we put onto those, that we put into the data source are not on the correct axis. Remember, we have a primary axis and a secondary axis going on here in this chart. So how you can fix that, how you can tell what's on what axis, go to that chart design tab up here, click on the change chart type icon. So change chart type icon on the ribbon right there, and you can see if you have a custom chart or a combo chart like this, you're going to get all of the different series, all the different columns of data, and then it's going to tell you what chart type it is and what axis it's on. And you can see that this label spacer right here was put onto my secondary axis by default. I want that to be on the primary axis because we need to have three on the primary axis and three on the secondary axis. My data is going to be on the primary axis with my little label spacer helper there, and my labels are going to be on the secondary axis. So let's go ahead and uncheck that box right there. Now you can see in my little preview window here, the chart is starting to look correct. So let's go ahead and say okay. And now you can see we have our spacer column, and this is where we are going to put our category labels: Hummingbird, Aviary, Splash, River Rapids, etc. Let's go ahead and right click to add labels. We're going to add those data labels there. And what we're gonna do is over here in the format label menu, instead of value, I'm gonna uncheck value and we're gonna say value from cells. This is where we are going to point to those category labels on the chart. We're gonna tell PowerPoint where we wanna put the, what labels we wanna put inside of those data labels. And I'm just gonna go ahead and drag this down right here all the way to Hummingbird Aviary and click okay. And there we go. You can see that my labels now have populated with the category labels from the axis. So at this point, let's go ahead and click on our axis. We're gonna go over to the format axis menu, click on labels dropdown, and under label position, let's go ahead and say none instead of next to axis. When I click on none, it's going to remove that axis right there. And I'm gonna click in the plot area. We can probably just drag this over to really fill the slide with my chart. Let's go ahead and that green column of data, that's just dummy data. We're going to make sure that that's filled with nothing, no fill, no line. And then we're going to switch the position of those labels to, right now they're outside the end of the bar. We're going to say inside base. And that puts them right on the inside of the base there. Here, it's just formatting. We can go ahead and click on Aptos. Maybe we wanted Aptos narrow, a nice condensed font right there. And I'm just going to increase the size of this, maybe all the way up to 18. You can see it wraps inside. If you don't want that wrapping feature for the text, just go over back to the format label data menu under this little size and position icon, click on that, and you can see this wrap text and shape is always selected by default. Let's unselect that, and then everything stretches to one line. Now, the thing is, there's a little bit of overlap here and on the bar, and that might be okay, and I'm wondering if we can maybe adjust it a little bit. And to do that, we might want to just work with our overlap or our gap width features here. So click on any of the bars. What we're going to do is actually I want to click on that ghost sort of labels of bar right there. You can see a series overlap. It's set to -5%. I wonder if we decreased it, what would happen? It does look like if we decrease it maybe to -15%, that makes it go up just a little bit more. And the thing is, if I want these to match, I'm going to click on the primary axis bars and let's go and decrease that to 15 and see what that does. That looks like maybe it also, it does look pretty good that way. So I think you just want to make sure that the gap width and the series overlap is set to the same values for both your primary axis and your secondary axis, okay? So this is a great chart. Look at how cool it looks. I think it looks really slick, really elevated. People will not know that you made this chart in PowerPoint. They will think that you probably made it in some design software, Illustrator or something like that. And they will be none the wiser that you made it in a software that you already have access to like PowerPoint. So I know this was kind of a really technical tutorial. If you could make your way through it, let me know in the comments below and let me know if you make a chart type like this. I really, really like it. Again, go back to our initial videos on how to make this one from scratch from the typical clustered bar chart. I think that will give you some of the answers if you don't quite know what we're talking about in this tutorial. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you and can't wait to see you next time.